The Bible teaches us that God is holy. In other words, God is completely unique. There is no one else like God, never has been, never will be, never can be. He alone is the creator, the absolute sovereign, the ultimate reality. The Bible also says that man is to be holy. That means we are to be entirely set apart for God, completely dedicated to the absolutely unique, holy God, with nothing in us or in our lives that is opposed to Him. This also means that we accept the fact that we are God's creation, one person among many people, all of us equal before God. Jesus summed it up this way: we are to love God with everything we are, and to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Both scripture and experience teach us that man is born unholy. We are naturally self-centered. We want to choose our own path. We want to go our own way. And so from earliest childhood, our lives are filled with acts of sin, acts of rebellion against God. When we are saved, our sins are forgiven, and we are restored to fellowship with God. But the inborn self-centeredness of the heart remains. This is a condition James calls being double-minded. Scripture speaks of a further work that God does in the hearts of believers. Acts calls it purifying our hearts. And it makes it clear that this is accomplished when the believer is filled with the Holy Spirit. Paul calls it perfecting holiness in 2 Corinthians and being entirely sanctified in 1 Thessalonians. The change that entire sanctification brings is deeper than emotion, deeper than choice, deeper even than consciousness. It changes who we are in the very core of our being. It changes the basic inclination of our heart from selfward to Godward. It's a deeper application of the same principle that undergirds all of Christianity: love God and love others. Entire sanctification does not change our personalities, our habits, or our learned responses, including emotional reactions. Your struggles, your temptations, even your reactions after entire sanctification can be much the same as before. What does change is the underlying tendency of your heart, from being, in the words of one hymn, prone to wander, prone to leave the God I love, to identifying with David when he proclaims, "My heart is steadfast, O God. I will sing praises even with my soul." Scripture tells of three requirements before God will entirely sanctify a person. First, you must already be saved. This is a work for believers. Second, you must be completely consecrated to God, what Romans calls a living sacrifice. And third, you must be in unity with fellow believers. We like to overlook that third one, but it is repeatedly emphasized in Scripture. But isn't that the way a Christian should live anyway? Yes, absolutely. Entire sanctification is not some weird mystical experience. It's the same principle of love God, love others. And guess what? The results of entire sanctification follow the same pattern. The indwelling Holy Spirit provides a deeper consecration to God, a consistent, joyful submission to God. And He enables us to enjoy deeper unity with other believers. Entire sanctification is the love God and love others principle, but applied in a deeper way. It becomes real, not just in your life, but in the hidden recesses of your heart.